fogo. Symbolizes the union between Christ and the church. That Christ sanctions marriage is evidenced by the fact that he honored an invitation to a wedding in Canaan of Galilee, and he performed his first miracle there. Also, Apostle Paul pointed out that marriage is honorable among men, therefore marriage should not be rushed into to satisfy carnal laws. It has to be approached with dignity and the fear of the Lord. Why is there marriage? Firstly, marriage is for mutual fellowship. Secondly, marriage is to check the sinful life of adultery so that those not gifted to be continent can marry and thus keep themselves holy as the body of Christ. Thirdly, marriage is ordained for the purpose of rearing children that will denounce to fear the Lord, abide with the teachings of his words, and glorify his holy name. This agreement these two have reached and are to be joined together. From the foregoing, therefore, if anybody has any reason or reasons they should not be joined in holy matrimony, such a person should mention it now. If there's none, let everybody remain silent in this marriage forever. Can I have an amen?
Amen.
All right. Now, all of you should realize that those joined, contrary to the word of God, are not acceptably joined together in the sight of the Almighty. Therefore, do any of you have reasons or reasons you should not be joined together in matrimony?
No reason.
Okay. Let's talk to our sister.
No reason.
No reason.
Let's see before we go, see who wish. Whom they brought today, can you obey me? Thank you. Good. Then face yourselves now.
Do you engage this woman in marriage and so that both of you will live together according to God's order of marriage? Will you love her, honor her, counsel her, nurse her both in the circumstance of plenty and poverty, sound health and illness? Will you leave other women and cleave to her alone as long as both of you shall live?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Sister Precious Ifeko, do you want this man to be your husband so that both of you will live together according to the will of God? Concerning marriage, will you have him, obey him? Will you love him, obey him, nurse him, both in the circumstance of plenty and poverty, sound health and illness? Will you reject other men and cleave to him alone as long as both of you are alive?
Yes, I will.
gave this woman out in marriage.
Thank you, sir.
Can you please clap for him? Thank you, sir. That is your father, brother. God bless you.
Hi, brother. I love your money.
I accept you.
Sister Precious. That's my wife. As from today. To have at your home. For better. For worse.
In plenty.
In plenty.
Good people are eyes. In health.
In health.
In sickness.
In sickness.
I will love you.
I will love you.
At nurse you.
At those.
And nurse you.
And nurse you.
According to the way of God.
According to the will of God.
According to the way of God.
According to the way of God.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Amen.
Amen. This Holy Bible, which is the Word of God, I bow you. I surrender myself to you.
Sacrifice.
And I will nurse you.
All
my possessions.
In the
name of the Father,
the Son,
and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I joyfully.
And wholeheartedly.
As a seal of our covenant today.
May God help me. Follow the guidance of the Word.
This cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh, so that they are no more to him but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. As Brother Falabi and Sister Precious have agreed to be joined in holy matrimony, even as they have confessed this before God and man, and backed it up with the giving and receiving of the Holy Bible as an everlasting testament, say that they should both live together as husband and wife as from today, in the name of the Father,
amen.
And of the Son,
amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The choir is there to celebrate Jesus in your life. I will pray that Jesus will put joy in your home. Be blessed as you listen to our ministration this morning, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
come, my father in the Lord, here present, for giving me this platform. I want to thank God for making this day a reality in the lives of these people. Precious and Apolabi, I want to say that you are gorgeous. I want to congratulate the Omodes for gaining another daughter in Precious. I pray that she will be forever precious to you in the mighty name of Jesus. For everyone here present, I want to say that we are not just mere spectators, but we are witnesses to this great mystery and miracle of the transformation of two people into becoming one. And therefore, I want to urge every person here present to hold these people, that is Precious and Apolabi, to hold them accountable for the vow they have made today. They have said, I do, in the presence of every one of us. And we should, you know, follow them up and make sure that, and hold them accountable and be sure that, you know, they do everything that we make them one. And God will bless all of us as we do that in Jesus' name.
Marriage, a lifelong union and covenant. Marriage, a lifelong union and covenant. Meant marriage to be 1 + 1 = 1. And so particularly, when it comes to the mathematics of God, with regards to marriage, 1 + 1 = 1. It has to do with Isaiah 1:19-20. And that says, if you are willing and obedient, then you will be fruit of the land. You will make your marriage successful if you are willing and you are obedient. And I urge you this morning to be willing and obedient. The very potent key of marriage is love. Marriage, you know, requires love. But marriage is not about love alone. That's the message I'm supposed to tell you. Because marriage is a spiritual thing. It is a covenant for each of you to be faithful to the end. It will be for better, for worse, in health, in sickness, in poverty, and in wealth. With our eyes closed and heads bowed,
we continue this service as we go into signing of the marriage register.
Thank you. on behalf of this, our children, we want to say thank you. Thank you for giving them the grace and faithful to witness in our own day. Ever before they were born, you knew that today will come to pass. We thank you for keeping them. We thank you for guiding them. We thank you for protecting them. Please accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Now they have been joined together as one. And as your representative, joining my faith with all your ministers here and parents, the pronouncements and blessings that will be released upon these your children, starting from this moment, that is answered by fire.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now we decree to your life that the flight of marriage that you have just budgeted will not crash.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That the seed of marriage that you have just entered into will not sink.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
There can be no arrival without a departure. You have not departed from being single. Now you are married. Every departure is an adventure, and every adventure is a risk. In your own case, you will arrive safely.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
On behalf of our Father and the Lord, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, I present this marriage certificate to you in the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Thank you very much. very good afternoon to you, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Rotimi Johnson. I'm going to be a wonderful anchor this afternoon.
Look at
day of your birth. Dijakuyi, and we have raised one song for one each team member, team bride and team groom. Let's go. DJ, stop it. Let's go, DJ.
Standing, please, can we still be upstanding, D.O.N., for the next 60 seconds, please,
And will please stop movement and stand. Thank you very much. God bless you. May his gentle soul rest in perfect peace. Thank you very much. You may take to your seat. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. I have been told to ask for Dr. Chigozie. My friend Godwin is a very good planner. You have succeeded. Thank you very much. I was wondering why Mr. and Mrs. Godwin Parker said I should be the chairman. I was wondering. Because in this fine business, I'm only a few days older than Precious and Bolami. I'm just 38 years and 9 days today in marriage. So, and I don't know how old you are, but just 38 years in marriage. And I remember when he was writing his thesis, too much of time was invested in talking to us. And I can tell you today, after 38 years, I can't remember one word of it. I can't remember a word of what the pastor said on that day. But what was in my mind? I was saying in my mind, Pastor, please release us so that we can go to reception where we have our friends. Because there is nothing the pastor was saying that I've never had before. So I was just praying, please release us. So we came to reception hall. The chairman there too started his own message, very long one. And I was saying in my mind, what else are you going to say that I never had before? I was saying in my mind, please, release us. So that we can, myself and my wife, can leave America and come down to Lagos. Because another party was waiting for us. So, there will always be something you are thinking about. But you know, in this marriage business, it's difficult to tell you, but the truth of the matter is that it is not easy. Perhaps the only person who can tell you it's easy will be a Catholic priest who has never been married. I have been married for 38 years and I tell you, it's not easy. But there's only one person who will make it easy for you, and that is Jesus Christ. Please, the love of Christ should be that we should bind you together. As a family, we should pray together. I know that you will disagree, but disagree to agree. And Lord, continue to be with you. Thank you.
Precious, put your hand on the knife. Afolabi, put your hand on her hand. That knife is meant for destruction. Please, I will say a prayer. What a powerful amen. From today henceforth, any man, short or tall, fat or slim, rich or poor, that will not allow Precious to rest again, Holy Ghost fire will consume him in Jesus' name. I know you people will say amen because you are full of jealousy. Women, is it in our body? Is it in our body? From today henceforth, any woman, tall or short, fat or slim, I will not allow Afolabi to rest. Only God will have mercy upon her in Jesus' name. I know you will not say amen. It's on your body. Now you're cutting this cake at the number of children you want in this marriage. The name of Jesus is so precious that I don't toy with it at events. They are just talking about family meeting here. I will start with the list number 10. 5 boys, 5 girls. Afolabi say, 10 children, 1.2 million per time. Times 10. No. 8. I should go higher. Afolabi, Seven. I for not be one to cut his precious head in his hand. Seven children. You want to kill me? You have got to walk. Yeah. Six. Five. The child is here. Four. Four children. Okocha's father is regretting that he doesn't have two of Okocha in his family. Three. Aha! A round of applause for them. They cut it at the number of three. As a correct Igbo girl that knows how to take care of their husband. Igbo girl, you get married to Igbo girl in less than 3 months. Go to your back and your front will shoot out. Be careful, though. Careful on the staircase. Ladies and gentlemen, precious, a well-cultured, a well-mannered lady has gone to feed her husband. Wait. Afolabi, she knelt down. Let her kneel down for 3 hours, so. After today, you won't get this kneeling down again, no? Except the day you buy Range Rover Sport. Sir, have you alive? The last time my wife knelt down for me was on our wedding day, and the day I got up to Toyota Camry. Yeah, feed your husband. Fantastic lady. She's feeding her husband, and we're all watching it. Please give him something to drink, preferable water. Ladies and gentlemen, I like this moment a lot because every time the couple go to watch their video, they will always remember this day and be happy about it. If you are not eating, it's either you are fasting or you are not with us. All right, please help your wife up. Be a romantic husband. Please sit down. Afolabi, it's your turn to feed your wife. The chairman is here. He knows how it's been done. Men association. Men are saying, this guy is so romantic. Give her something to drink. Water. Just give her water so that when your children ask you, Daddy, you only fed mommy, you didn't give her water. So you will hold the cup, Afolabi, you had the money. She wants to hold it herself. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's fantastic. Please come up for public declaration. Don't sit down. Public declaration is alone. Sir, doctor, sir, I want you to watch how they will kiss your daughter in your presence. Sir, there is nothing you will do. You will just be watching it, they will kiss your daughter in your presence. Mommy Afolabi, come and watch your son kissing another man's daughter publicly. So you hold yourself, sir, I want you to be watching it. Don't expect, hold the hand, face each other. Time. I'll count 1 to 10, I'll be very fast. 1, 2, 2, 2, baby, my precious, kiss that son, Tiri, hold it to 4, kiss, 5, 6, go ahead, 1 to 10, I say 10, you stop, 7, go and move your lips, Afolabi, 8, I'm still there, just 2 more to go, 8 and a half, 9, 1 more time, Afolabi, 10, go to DJ, it's okay, and this is a good shade, but why you want that? Get in, put your hand on your head. Hachikapusku, Garika Bumba, Davis, Odo, Paramale. Precious, come like this. You'll be calling for love. You, brothers, do well. Let's go. Hachikapusku, Garika Bumba, Davis, Kadunia, Desi. Go around. Shaman, what do we do? Shaman,
You are the head of this. Someone say carry her. Someone say carry her. Carry her. Carry her. Carry her.
Thank you. Thank you. Come on, this is for you. Now you see, I'm a rich old man. Hey, hey, hey.